everybody, Mark here from 8 Minute Axe. Today I'm going to count down what, in my opinion, are the top 10 greatest guitar solos of all time. And just to make it a little more interesting, I'm going to play my number one live here in the studio. So make sure you stick around to see whether or not I nail it or fail it. I do want to stress that these are my top 10 picks. I'm sure you all have vastly different opinions on what the 10 greatest solos of all time are, so please leave a comment with your list. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say about my picks and what your picks are. And I'm going to do a follow-up video based on your responses, and if you want to take it a step further, shoot a video of yourself playing your favorite solo, and I may feature it in that video. If you're new to the channel, please take a moment, hit the subscribe button, ring the bell to get notified when I upload new videos, and all of you, please hit the like button. It only takes 1 second, and I really do appreciate it. Okay, so let's jump right into it. Coming in at number 10 is none other than the maestro himself, Eddie Van Halen's solo on Michael Jackson's Beat It. It's part of music history now, but the idea of Eddie shredding over a pop song, and one by Michael Jackson no less, was nothing short of revolutionary at the time. Right from that first razor-sharp note, it's Eddie Van Halen from beginning to end. He makes no concessions, and I believe it's his finest solo on record. And the fact that all he got paid was a 12-pack of beer makes it that much more legendary and cool. Coming in at number 9 is While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Anyone who follows the channel knows that I'm a huge Beatles fan, and while George, John, and Paul all had their share of great solos, I believe that the best solo on a Beatles song came from an uncredited guest. The fact that said guest was Eric Clapton didn't hurt, though. If you look at the solo tabbed out, it seems so simple, but in Clapton's hands, it's pure magic. Imagine the pressure, too, being invited to a Beatles session to play on a Beatles record on a song called While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Clapton totally nails it, though. Every note is bent, squeezed, and wrung out to perfection. Number 8 on the countdown is Terry Kath's solo on Chicago's 25 or 6-4. Jimi Hendrix once called Terry Kath the best guitar player in the world. Terry's unique style is in full display on this extended solo. He starts off with a somewhat meandering melody punctuated by half-step resolutions. The second half of the solo is classic Kath, dirty and frenetic. When it seems like there's nowhere else to go, he kicks in the wall and takes an already brilliant solo totally over the top. Unfortunately, Terry Kath's career was cut short. He died tragically in 1978 when he accidentally shot himself, and the world lost one of the most underrated and best guitar players of all time. Okay, so every countdown needs a dark horse pick to really personalize the list for its creator. For me, that pick came in at number 7, and it's Buck Dharma's solo on Blue Oyster Cult's Burnin' For You. I remember the first time I saw the video, I thought two things. One was, wow, that's an amazing guitar solo, I have to learn it. And two, why the hell did they shoot this video on a highway underpass? If you've seen the video, you know what I'm talking about. Seriously, if you're unfamiliar with the solo, never really gave it a good listen, or just haven't heard it in a while, treat yourself. It's smooth, flawlessly played, and a perfect example of Buck's understated style. Number 6 on the list is Slash's solo on Sweet Child of Mine. It's well known that Slash came up with the opening riff while he was messing around between takes on another song. It's also well known that to this day he maintains that the riff is silly and that Sweet Child of Mine is one of Guns N' Roses' worst songs. I love everything about this solo. The only thing I don't love is the fact that Slash said that he did it in one take. Sometimes it takes me two takes just to tune my guitar. For a spontaneous solo, Slash executes what I think is a perfect example of a solo that continues to build and build to an ultimate climax. The addition of the wah pedal seals it for me as one of the best solos of all time. Coming in at number 5 is an example of me having to give credit where credit's due. Yes, it's Hotel California. Many of you know of my ongoing feud with Don Henley, and it seems like this song just keeps popping up in my lists. It just shows what a magnanimous guy I am. Don Felder and Joe Walsh apparently spent 3 days sitting on stools across from each other working out all the parts. One story has it that when they finally got down what they thought was the take, they went out to dinner. At dinner, they looked at each other and said, we could do better. They ran back to the studio, and in one take, they laid down what is the classic solo that we all know and love. Other accounts challenge the veracity of this story, but the romantic in me is going to stick with it. Coming in at number 4 is David Gilmour's solo on Another Brick in the Wall Part 2. When I said David Gilmour, I'm sure many of you expected me to say Comfortably Numb or Time, but to me, Another Brick in the Wall is David Gilmour's finest. All of the elements that make Gilmour Gilmour are here, but with extra attitude. Perfectly timed and perfectly in tune bends, beautiful melodic lines one after another in well-placed double stops. What seals the deal for me, though, are all the great ghost notes. It's also what makes a solo very challenging to perfect. And then there were three. In reality, any of my top three could have taken the top spot on any given day, but I love lists, and I hate it when people do top 10 lists and don't put them in order. So today, this is my order. Coming in at number three is Jimi Hendrix's version of All Along the Watchtower. This song could have made number one simply because you get four Hendrix solos in one song. By the time Hendrix recorded Electric Ladyland, he became obsessed with perfection. The sessions are infamous for endless takes and Hendrix just trying to get every single aspect of each song perfect. Eddie Kramer, who engineered the album, though, says that this was not the case on All Along the Watchtower. Hendrix had recorded all the backing tracks, and all he needed to do now was lay the four solos down. And even though he did each take individually, Kramer says that it took him maybe a total of 2 hours to nail all four. Hendrix insisted on a different sound for each solo, and everything good about Hendrix is here. His classic catch and release bends are done to perfection. It has maybe the best use of a wah pedal ever in a song. And to top it off, that sweet slide part, which apparently he played with the back of a cigarette lighter. Coming in at number two on my list is the song that tops most lists, Stairway to Heaven. Page had been working on the idea of a song that continues to build and build to a huge crescendo for many years, and he had been collecting different acoustic parts. When he finally strung together those parts, the song came very quickly. There's not much I can say about the solo that hasn't already been said. Although Page admits that he had sketched out the general idea for the solo beforehand, when it came to the final take, he proudly says, "I winged it." There isn't a single wasted note in this solo, and even after hearing it 1,000 times, I never tire of it, and I still love it to this day. Okay, before I reveal my number one, I want to mention a few songs that almost made the cut. Mark Knopfler's solo on Sultans of Swing, Martin Barre's solo on Aqualung, Randy Rhoads' solo on Crazy Train, Ritchie Blackmore's solo on Burn, and Dickie Betts' solo on Blue Sky. All those were in the mix, but they just didn't make the final cut. At least today they didn't. Without further ado, coming in at number one is Larry Carlton's brilliant solo on Steely Dan's Kid Charlemagne. In a 2012 interview, Fagan described Larry Carlton as a virtuoso who can get around his instrument better than any other studio guitarist. According to Fagan, Carlton did two takes of the solo and parts of each were used in the final version. The way Carlton navigates through the complex set of chord changes in the background is brilliant. And now for the moment you've all been waiting for, I'm gonna plug in, get set up, and I'm gonna knock this solo out. I'm gonna do it using my brand new Epiphone 339 P90 Pro. I just got this a couple days ago. It sounds awesome and I'm excited to use it on this tune. All right, I've got everything queued up. And I'm gonna record direct, but I've got the amp on so you can hear it. Let's rock and roll. Get the that's all I have for today. Please make sure you leave a comment and leave your list for me. I'd love to see what you guys come up with. If you want to send me a video, please email it to markaranalli@gmail.com. I will make another video based on your comments, and I'd love to include a couple of your solos in that video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell to get notified when I upload new videos. And most importantly, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.